Oh. Bringing back some weird type
horror elements. This reminds me of the intro to Over Enemy with the voices and like the radio.
Of course, that's very scary.
Yeah, this is just kind of horror. Oh.
Got that, yeah, that low-key mellow feel.
Yeah. I'll say, I love when they do this. It switches things up, it keeps things different. It stands out. Ooh.
Very ambient, atmospheric.
That song did a lot. It did a lot.
Yeah.
And it sounds like nothing, and I mean nothing, on the rest of this album.
Yeah. Another fascinating way that they keep changing it up here. Yeah, really, really interesting.
Here you go. With Seven Faces that had Kerry King had just solo. This song has just Jeff Hanneman having a solo, so it kind of evens things out between the two of them.
Yeah.
I don't know who took the Bloodline solo. It sounds like it's a Kerry King solo, yeah. So maybe we get another one of those Jeff-only things. Yeah. So we'll see. All right.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's go. Warzone.
Oh, nice.
Machine gun? Is that a machine gun I hear? Really smooth change in the feel there. Really smooth.
Yes.
Again, like, really, like, smooth. Like, just switching it up a little bit.
Explosive! You feel the impact in your face. What makes you think you're late?
That double bass is working overtime. Sounds amazing. Fucking heavy, man.
Oh.
Oh, add the doubles. Add the doubles. Oh my god.
Paul's
going fucking wild. We're bringing back that original.
Paul is killing it on this track. The Tom Phil. Oh, man.
That's the most balls to the walls we've had since Disciple. I mean, seriously. I mean, we haven't gotten that crazy.
Oh, it's unreal.
On the whole album.
Paul shines on this track.
Big time.
Best part of the track.
Amazing. Amazing.
Oh, my gosh.
Just from the feel changes in the beginning, kind of in those grooves, to that second
Tom fills and just... second verse that he just started just having basically just the fills be the... part.
So good. So yeah, he absolutely destroyed it on that song.
Yeah, he destroyed it.
It's fast, great drumming. Gotta love it. I got nothing else to say. I mean, it's just fucking just hits heavy, man.
Well, and I think that that was great.
Yeah. Good shit. All right. Longest song by a long shot.
Only song that's over 4 minutes.
Yep. So
Then do you just want to jump right into Payback? Because we've already heard it.
No, I'd say let's talk about it because we could lose it. Let's talk about it.
Oh!
That sounds like lower.
That does not sound like drop C even. It's gotta be like drop B, maybe even drop A. Like, dang! Harry doing some something. Hold this. Oh!
I didn't expect it to go there. I expected it to be like way slow.
Ooh. Ooh!
That was like so like... That was like very quick but very smooth.
I think it helps with the riff with no drums.
Smoother.
I think that helps.
Like, not just like here's something. It's like very cohesive. You got those little swells, you know. Those
yes.
Are cool.
Yeah.
vocal layering.
That's a really nice cadence. Like that, the vocals provide the drive.
Yes.
That's really cool. I hear a riff. There's a riff somewhere in there.
Yep. There it is. That riff is distinctly Slayer. Distinctively.
Oh, go ahead, I mean. Again, took us to dump to different places, but I was saying, like, it felt like everything was way more cohesive. It wasn't as sudden. Like, here's one way. Like, there was, like, ways that they orchestrated it to move.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like that was, like, a big difference maker between this and the rest of the album.
Well, seeing the length, too, I also thought, I also kind of expected this to be a little slower.
Yeah, totally.
But I liked the drive that they had. It kind of bit more mid-tempo during the verses.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think part of it, that transition works so well because they had an isolated, they isolated the riff for a bar or two and then brought the rest of the band in.
That helps.
Cool. Oh, yeah.
So,
and they really slowed it down
at
the beginning. And like when they,
it was like really,
it's like doom metal.
It was really slow.
Yeah, okay, maybe not that slow.
But so there we go. That's our last one. We'll blaze through Payback here, literally.
Literally.
And then we'll give our last thoughts. It's very interesting how misleading this song is, though, because it is nothing like the rest of the album. Like, maybe kind of like Disciple, and a little bit like Warzone.
That's the song on the album.
It's like, it's so different than everything else. Great closer, though. Absolutely amazing.
God, I love this song.
Like, oh, dude. What a live tune, you know? Like, God.
Oh, my God.
Crowd moving. It's like, this song is like classic Slayer formula, right? And they break it down the middle, and then you take it back in fast with a solo. You know, it's just like every like good classic like thrashy Slayer songs. And, mm-hmm. It gets a little bit heavier and slower than songs like, you know, like War Ensemble or yeah. Angel of Death, but you know, it does it well. Yeah, that's God Hates Us All. Interesting record, man. Interesting record.
Now, the real, the million dollar question here. Does God really hate us all?
That's for...
That's not for me to decide. That's not for me to decide.
But yeah, really interesting record. I anticipated, like I said, in terms of expectations, I anticipated more thrash, less... new metal, and just I guess from hearing Payback, you know, you think, oh, we're getting more like fast stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's not the case, and that's okay.
Well, I expected it to be a bit of a mix of the two.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't expect it to be
a mix. Like, I just felt like it was really groovy and mm-hmm. not a lot. Like, I expected, even in terms of a mix, like I just expected more. And besides Disciple and Warzone, I mean, we really didn't get any, like, true thrash metal.
You get Exile.
We got, like, a half. Again, no bad song. I'm just saying I wouldn't call it a thrash song.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, they still had kind of the experimental vocal stuff and kind of had, I don't know, you know, they kept trying new things, which is always awesome. But
my perception of this album before listening to it was the best, like the highlight of this, these three, and what many could say, like, tumultuous period in terms of, like, kind of like discovering and trying some new things.
Every, you know, 80s band,
About the big four, all the 90s were not super kind,
very weird time. Like the late 90s, early 2000s, because early 90s we got a bunch of bangers.
Yeah, I mean, you got Rust in Peace, Season of the Abyss, Black Album,
you know. So like early 90s, yeah, but as the 90s progressed on and, you know, the new metal movement started out, you know, of course with 94,
you got Eyeballs for Slayer, you got Risk for Megadeth, you got Stomp 442 from Anthrax, and then you got Low Reload and Saint Anger for Metallica.
Yeah, so it was a very odd period, of course, for everyone. And, you know, Slayer.
Well, still discovering. They were kind of just trying to try some new things.
Yeah.
You know, kind of get with the times.
So, you know, and it was no different for Slayer. But, you know, again, we talked about this constantly. There was still always distinctively Slayer in the record.
And to me, that's exactly why I don't think this album per se would have per se aged poorly.
Yeah.
Unlike other albums from this time period,
sure.
I think that, you know, because it still has those elements of a Slayer song that you'd expect from an album by Slayer. So I think in that facet, it's not something that you say per se aged horribly. Of course, you can have your own opinion on saying, like, oh, well, I don't think they should have done the groove stuff and blah blah blah. They should, you know, but you know, we got what we got, and I think that this is a really good project. There are definitely some good highlights here, and I think that's a good segue into some best moments for you.
I liked it. I'm excited to sit down with it. That's really where I'm at. Oh, okay. Disciple, obviously, is, a unanimous highlight. I like Warzone a lot, but I feel like it's the easy pick. I feel like it's the cop-out, you know?
fun and fast, you know, so you could easy cup out. So I'd say New Faith actually enjoyed a bit. It got interesting, but I remember really liking it. I'm really liking the groove there. And maybe Bloodline. I liked Here Comes the Pain. I did.
Yeah, I think it was a really interesting song. I think between Bloodline and Here Comes the Pain, I think I'll take the more interesting out of the box Here Comes the Pain. So there you go. Disciple, New Faith, Here Comes the Pain. There you go.
I'm going to go with that so-called cop-out. I'm going Disciple, Warzone, and New Faith.
That's what mine would be if I didn't skip over Warzone.
Yeah. And of course, I'll have Bloodline and Payback. But I'll also highlight Exile and I'll highlight Cast Down as well. Really enjoyed those two tracks as well, along with Here Comes the Pain.
Yeah.
Overall, I enjoyed this project. I did. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's get our game done with. Let's go.
Oh. Yes, you are right. I forgot about this.
Come on, man. You're not even prepared.
I guess I'm not. Yeah, I'm unprepared. I got the article. Don't worry. It's pretty much.
All right. So I'm guessing most, least, and what they haven't played.
Yes. So okay. I've been quizzing
most,
him.
Most is Disciple.
Yes. 1,103 times. Flat.
Okay. How many have they not played?
There are 6 songs on this album that have not been played live.
Fucking okay, we're gonna start with God Send Death.
No. Exile. Exile, yes. There's
Seven Faces.
Yes. There's one that's pretty obvious.
Mm-hmm. Here Comes the Pain.
No. You're missing the
Darkness of Christ.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Darkness of Christ, Exile, Seven Faces.
Wasn't anything but Threshold? 3.
Nope.
Cast Down.
Yes. 2 more.
Deviance?
Yes.
More. Yeah. New Faith?
Nope.
What have I not said? I said Exile?
Yes, you already did.
Okay. I said Seven Faces.
Yes. Darkness of Christ, Cast Down. Yes, Warzone.
Wow.
Final one. Darkness of Christ, Cast Down, Exile, Seven Faces, Deviance, Warzone. We're not played live.
From the least of the ones that have been played, I'm going to say God Send Death.
Nope.
I'm going to say Here Comes the Pain. I'm going to say Exile. Oh, wait, no, that one hasn't been played. Threshold.
No.
Deviance?
Yeah, that one hasn't been played at all.
Bloodline.
No.
At this point, I should just read down the whole fucking thing. Disciple, God Send Death, New Faith.
There you go.
New Faith?
Yep.
New Faith.
36 times.
Good job, everyone.
Good job.
Just fucking slammed
it. Dude, he's slowing down. He nailed the first couple albums, I'm telling you.
What are you, like, this, it doesn't make sense anymore. It doesn't make sense anymore, Alex.
Yeah.
Whatever. With that, we're gonna call it. So thank you so much for everyone who tuned in. Go watch the rest of the ones that have been done so far, and if you're lucky enough, new ones have already been put out, so you can watch as many as you like. But yeah, thank you guys so much, and yeah, see you guys in the next one.